Nigeria's diversification strategic initiative, especially to agriculture, to continue to receive enough capital to run the system, receive participation from the private sector. ABX World Cargo's chief executive, Captain John Okpapu, speak with Inside Business in our special report on the industry. We have a focus. Still on the agri sector, the Stein Industries Limited received commendation for staying the course in the agri sector. We have a feature. CED Magazines named the first set of built environment evergreen professionals. Engineer Charles Aladewolu is on the card. This is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Hello and thanks for joining us. My name is Kenneth Odushola Stevenson and this is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. We'll be talking largely about Nigeria's government's effort to diversify the economy using the agriculture as a tool and indeed to receive enough capital to run the economy. Several private sector operators are currently queuing up with many industrial and very strategic initiatives to take advantage of these opportunities. We'll talk about all that plus other interesting issues on business, finance and the economy when we come back right after this commercial break. Welcome back. You're still Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Thanks for staying with us. The Nigeria's government's effort at diversifying the economy, especially to agriculture, is receiving a lot of applause from the private sector. An organization that is doing a very strategic thing for the industry, ABX World Cargo. We'll be talking with the chief executive officer of that organization to look at what kind of platform they have and what got him into what they are doing today. Let me use this opportunity to welcome Captain John Okpaku to Inside Business Africa. Thank you again for joining us on this special edition of the program looking at agriculture and the nation's economy.
Thank you.
Let me go straight to ask my first question. Really, I would like to begin. How did you find yourself in this agricultural sector in Nigeria? You know, what brought you here, really? How did you get here?
Well, actually, yes, I say that. But I will look at it as an economics, not into agriculture. I'm a pilot by profession. And been in the aviation industry most part of my life. We ventured into airline business, and the airline business that I'm more familiar with, it's a cargo airline business. So, and looking at agriculture is the only way out to fuel the airplane. And it came to my mind, and I said, oh, okay, now let's see how to get people products, actual product out of Nigeria. So it's in that process that I looked and said, oh my God, I can even do that too. What is the reason? No Nigerian government, not state government, not local government, none of this arm of government is approved or got any certification to export any agricultural products. In Kenya, they have over 1,800 certified global GAP organization that exports agricultural product. In South Africa, they have over 1,700. In Egypt, over 660. In Cote d'Ivoire, that came the fourth position, over 350. Then Ghana, Cameroon, Togo, Rwanda of yesterday, Nigeria, zero. And I go, wow. That's a problem. That is when I got to work. Okay? And I said, okay, for the meantime, we have to start exporting while we're building the capacity and put them together and so that I can be able to fill my aeroplane. So not only my aeroplane, all cargo airlines, other airlines coming to Nigeria can fill the aeroplane. And by me doing so, reduce the air freight cost Nigerians have been suffering for years, paying unnecessarily. And thereby creating jobs and income to millions of Nigerians. That's how I got into this.
That's quite encouraging. Now, the federal government effort at making agriculture the number one economic driver in Nigeria must have also attracted you to this industry. What about the policies, and how do we look at Nigeria's economy vis-a-vis agriculture and what it can do for us?
Practically, I would say that we don't have any policy in place for agricultural exports. Now, look at, for you to engage in agricultural exports, the port of exit must be operated in 24 hours, 24/7. In Nigeria, for example, most of the warehouses we have in Nigeria, either the airport or the seaport, operates between 9:30 to 4:30, working days only. Now, look at most of the products that exit Nigeria, that will be exiting Nigeria. These products are some of the products that you can handle at late night. If you have a departure from Nigeria, let's say Arik Airline or Virgin Airline leaving Nigeria at 10:30, 11 o'clock, and the custom is resuming work at 9:30, how do you process the product? You can't. So the policies, first of all, is something the government have to look into. Putting the right policy in place in terms of where you process products, you package products. Not only have them at the airport, you can have them around in the inland, in different cities.
Well, Nigeria is an import-dependent economy, and I just don't believe that we should do the same thing what we're doing by exporting our crude and bringing in refined products, and at the end of the day, we are consuming what we also produce and importing them. Now, in the agriculture sector, this is the change period in this country, and we want to do things differently. What do you think that the government can do and the policies that could be put in place to encourage export of agricultural produce from Nigeria so that we can earn enough foreign exchange to boost our external reserves?
First of all, I would say the main machine they need to put in place is empowerment. Empowerment of the people. And when I'm talking about empowerment, we look at training and certifying the farmers, empower them at grassroots level. We look at ShopRite today. That's, our farmers cannot sell a lot, cannot sell anything to ShopRite. Our own ShopRite in our own country. What is the reason? ShopRite is part of GlobalGap. And if you don't have GlobalGap certification, you can't sell to ShopRite. So if we are selling tomato, and you get a certificate, global gas certification for tomato, you have an outlet where your product can be bought at the market. But for you to do that, we need to train and certify the farmers so that they can know the do's and the don'ts involved in the farming, in the production, and also the type of the chemical to be used. So mine is, first of all, the government should embark on empowerment, training and certify the farmers. That is the major.
Well, if you are going to do export, also meet international standards in terms of your produce, you need to have partners, most importantly, international partners. Who are your partners and who are the people that are actually working with you to reposition your establishment and also the agro-ally sector for export in Nigeria?
Yes, I'm a partner with Arik Airline. Arik is a major partner in this project. Because if you're looking at agro-allied, one of the major challenges in allied is logistics. And Arik filled in perfectly in this area. They operate flights to many parts of the world, to many parts of African country, to many parts of Nigeria. So now when the farm products are ready, you are sure of getting it from one point to the other. Then the other partner we work with is SACOR. SACOR is the handling company that process and package these products in the pallet for us to load it in plane. They play the major part. So I'm very happy that SACOR, under the leadership of Dr. Folabi Taiwo, has embarked on expanding the export processing unit.
We've been talking about policies and initiative and all of that. People would think that, yes, it's agriculture. Could we be specific about some of the products you are also into? In other words, what do we intend to produce for Nigerian market and also for export from your organization?
First of all, when I got into this, I did a lot of case study around the world to look at the product we can export out of Nigeria. Number one product, global world-class product we have in Nigeria is Nsukka yellow pepper. This is a product that cut across every country, every tribe, every race, every color. But they don't even export it. The ones you see in Europe, in America, comes from Uganda, from Cameroon, from Jamaica. Why we have the best here? What is the reason? Because they are not trained, processed, and certified to do so. Then coming on the another product that currently is flooding the market, it's a leaf called Ogo. I said Ogo. Ogo is a Nigerian word. It's a Nigerian name. It's an Igbo name, Ogo. Let me sound like Zegodaya. In English interpretation, pumpkin leaf. This is a machine in Nigeria. Ogo, you can look at it. It's 1,000,000% better than the spinach we all eat in Europe and North America. Why are they not eating Ogo? Because we are not having our act together. Now, there's something that is going to happen in this country, but heaven forbid, as long as I live, it will not happen. Now, let me put it this way. In the late 50s and the late 60s, and the 60s, 50s and the 60s, the Malaysian people came to Nigeria and take sample of our palm oil. Today, as I'm speaking to you, Malaysia controls the production and the market of palm oil. Where are we? Ogo has become another world-class product. It has better mineral and vitamin contents than the spinach they eat. Now all we have to do is to find a way to package it properly and sell it to the world. You know what is going on now? The Cameroonians, the Ghanaians have started growing Ogo. And you know another foreign country that is coming into it? Vietnam. And I'm saying to my government, please, this will not happen again. Please. That is one of the reasons I'm canvassing for air freight subsidy from the government. We get air freight subsidy. $93 million a year on air freight subsidy can create more than 20 million jobs. Keep our product that God gave us called Ogo. We have to keep it. We must keep our product, or else it will be the story of palm oil. And heaven forbid, it will not happen in my lifetime.
The federal government, yes, and some states are already doing very well in terms of agriculture. We know that Anambra is almost self-sustaining in terms of rice production, really. Now, let's talk about the nation's economy and the support from state government that you may be receiving as we speak now. Are there any state governments on your platform actually to actually encourage you to expand your investment layout?
All the proposals will put up different states. It's only one state, just one, that showed concern. It was Anambra State. Anambra State now responded positively to our proposal. And that was why we kind of paid more attention to Anambra, because they were receptive. The first thing I asked the government to do is to train the farmers, not on the global card level, on just the first simple level. Give them the skill they need to be able to produce this product. And the governor, Chief Widu Obiano, made the funds available. We brought in the trainers from Europe. They trained some of these farmers, certified them. And believe me, I'm using this opportunity to ask other governments in Nigeria, we need to get involved and go to Anambra State and take the chapter from their book. And the governor is not relenting. As I'm speaking to you, it's his number one policy. And I'm taking this opportunity to ask other states, although yes, Ondo State have just joined Anambra State. Ondo State. And I'm happy. They've already making very serious attempt to follow the footsteps of Anambra State.
Well, let's look at some of the governments. Yeah, we've talked about state also right now, but now the federal government, this diversification effort is quite unique indeed, and everybody has been embracing it. And it's been said over and over again, we must diversify. And let's be very sure that agriculture is going to actually do a lot of magic for the nation's economy. What do you think government should do to boost the agricultural production in Nigeria, and also encourage stored, you know, storage facilities, so that at the end of the day, when you are exporting these products, you will meet international standard. And also to talk about sustainability of some of the policies that may be put in place, so that at the end of the day, we don't wake up 2 years, 3 years down the line and we say, look, it's no longer working.
They have to look at providing some of the structures the farmers will need. But like I said earlier, I think the most basic thing, first of all, the government has to do, without going into any more detailed and sophisticated program, is to train and empower and certify these people. That is the most basic and the main important. Removing some of the policy that will hinder the growth of agriculture, especially in export, because there are some of the policies in place in agriculture. One of them, let me just hit on it before I go back to my section.
Yes.
One of them is some monetary policy involved in agriculture. There's this policy where you export more than 1 ton, you have to remit your funds through the official central bank system.
Yes.
No mass. Got to be free.
Well, straight away, Captain Opaku, now, how do we ensure we attain self-sufficiency in food production in Nigeria, from your expert's point of view?
There are so many. First of all, you have to look at what is going on in northern Nigeria, especially the Boko Haram.
Okay.
It is a problem. It's very, very sad. The issue of the pollution in the Niger Delta, in the northeast. Once we get our agricultural program going, Nigerian citizens will be able to go and farm and sell their product and earn a living. They will not be joining Boko Haram, killing people, because they can earn a living in a very decent way. Richest people in the world, they are farmers. In America, where I grew up, in San Francisco, San Joaquin Valley, from Sacramento, California to Los Angeles, through Fresno and Bakersfield, these are the biggest farm settlements in America. These people are billionaires.
Now let's talk about Nigeria. The oil industry, like we all know, is bedeviled with this corruption, and we don't know how many products we sell, and we don't know what we are selling. We don't even have any statistics to say that we produce so much. We only talk about it, but really, now, and that breeds corruption. What is your take on the corruption situation in Nigeria and the current governments are actually fighting corruption, and also some of your suggestions as to how we can actually ensure the agricultural sector, especially, is sustainable, corruption-free, and the nation can benefit from this particular initiative?
Yes, I support them fighting corruption, because you know these people have murdered so many people. Millions of Nigerians have died because of corruption. Corruption has eaten so deep in our system that it already become our culture. Thank God to Bishop Oyedepo, what he said, we should make sure we keep our local way of thinking to aid ourselves. We must have to do things that make us Nigerian and African. And I must have to say this, no matter how anybody claim to love you, you love yourself more than what other people love you. Do you understand me? So looking at that area, corruption, yes, we need to fight it. We have to fight it to a standstill. And that is one of the reasons I said, okay, let's start all over. Let's just start from the beginning. Grant amnesty, back. Anything forward, death penalty, period.
Well, finally, let's talk about your economic advice to the federal government. You are a private sector operator. You are participating in this economy. So you must have something you want to tell the government to actually be able to do to encourage people like you and many other investors to do very well and also continue to play their role in growing the nation's economy. Your advice?
I will tell him to put everything he has on agriculture. Everything. With agriculture, we will have balanced economy. Balanced economy. I know there's this issue of who owns the oil. The oil is in our land. This one is in our place. I believe once we develop agriculture, it will arrest that thinking. Oh yes. Once we develop and build agricultural sector, nobody will say this is our own, that one is our own. It will have a balanced system. So I will tell him to stick on agriculture, and by me doing so, empower the people.
Thank you very much, Captain Opaku, for joining us on Inside Business Africa for today and sharing your thoughts, especially on some of the platforms you are actually bringing into this industry, agricultural sector, and also your participation in the Nigerian economy, which we expect will be sustainable and also grow your organization and the national economy. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
We've been speaking with Captain John Opaku, the chief executive of ABS. You heard him talk about so many things, especially in partnership with so many organizations to ensure sustainability of the initiative. When we come back right after this commercial break, we'll still talk agriculture, but this time to a rice producer. Welcome back. It's still Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Stein Industries Limited is an Unewi Anambra state-based organization that is into rice production. Recently, that particular organization received commendation for contribution to the nation's economy, especially in the agri sector. And Inside Business Africa went after him. Here's what we brought for you. More or less, 70% of Nigeria's population engages in agricultural production at subsistence level. However, much of the Nigerian economy since the discovery of oil is driven by oil. With the advent of oil, agriculture was relegated to the background, and despite this unfortunate situation, the sector remained and accounts for about 42% of the gross domestic product GDP. Following the world food crisis and particularly the worsening food security situation in Africa, heads of states and government of Africa at the summit in Maputo in 2004 decided to provide a stronger political support to the Comprehensive Africa Agricultural Development Program, CAADP. Also, greater proportion of the population depend on the agricultural sector for their livelihood, and the rural economy is still basically agricultural. The role of the agricultural sector in the overall response of the Nigerian economy to reforms and adjustment policies is very important because, given its relatively large size, a large positive response to adjustment policies was expected as a means of improving the overall performance of the economy.
Farmers have been encouraged so far. That's the CBN Anchor Program, that the FADAMA Program, there are so many programs encouraging farmers to start planting. Now, when they finish that planting, is this not contrary to the government policy of trying to encourage farming by providing the funds for the Anchor CBN Anchor program? That Anchor program is designed in a way that the mills will absorb the rice. Well, we feel good being adjudged the best producer of the best rice 2016 in Africa. It's very encouraging. It's truly, when we were called upon on this, we felt a bit, I don't know the words to use, but we felt, could this be real? Because we didn't know anyone in that organization before now. We've heard about the organization, and even up till now, we still did not know anyone. Quite unlike other awards that they will call you, ask you to pay X amount of money before you receive the award. We were just called and told that congratulations, we've won the Best Rice Award. Are we happy to come to Sheraton to receive the award on so and so date? And we were like, why not? And after that, we were waiting to hear the next stage of it, of how much we are going to pay. And that never happened, which surprised us. And even after the award, nobody still came to me to ask, can I have your card? I will call you later to tell you what needs to happen. Up to now, we still do not know anyone in that organization. So we commend such organizations. Those are the sort of organizations that we need in Nigeria, and where they will recognize things based on its merit alone, not the power of how much that company can pay to receive such award. That's a very surprising thing to us about the award. So we're quite happy that we received such an award, and we're quite happy that our hard work over the years.
I And finally, on today's edition of the program, Engineer Charles Aladewolu is the chief executive of Teco Nigeria Limited. This particular organization has put in over 35 years into the nation's economy, especially in the engineering sector, from the manufacturing to agro-allied and many others. This particular organization and the chief executive has done very, very well. And no wonder, he was recently conferred with the CED Magazine's Built Environment Evergreen Professionals. Here's the presentation.
Sir, congratulations. Construction and Engineering Digest Magazine covered the Built Environment. And for the past 23 years, it's been. And I see this opportunity to present this certificate to you. I read certificate of recognition presented to Engineer Charles at the Ibuli Alago. This certificate of recognition is a confirmation of yourself as one of the Nigerian evergreen environment professionals that has contributed immensely to the infrastructural development in Nigeria. Congratulations.
Well, thank you very much. It's my thanks to Construction and Engineering Digest. I think it's one of the foremost magazines in Nigeria. They have been promoting engineering and construction these past very many years. And we are very happy to be associated with you and to be so recognized. And you can count on our support that we can continue to contribute to the economic development of Nigeria and to the promotion of the engineering profession.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Teco Limited, we have been around for 36 years, and all these years we have trained quite a number of Nigerian engineers, and we have handled some very interesting projects, and the joy of it all is that all our projects stand out today to testify of the credibility of Nigerian professionals. We specialize in the area of agro-allied business. We do a number of palm oil mills for the extraction of palm oil from palm fruits, and we have built quite a number in different parts of the country. I remember years ago, all the equipment were being imported from Europe and from other places. Then about 21 years ago, we built our own factory in Nigeria, our own workshop, where we fabricate equipment locally. And I'm happy to say that the quality of the equipment we fabricate here in Nigeria, the qualities are just as good as anyone they were importing from Europe. So I think once you train people and you have the facilities available, you can compare with any other engineer from anywhere. Yeah, well, I thank CED for the award.
Okay.
I think it's just an encouragement.
Yes.
It shows that people are watching what we are doing.
Yeah.
And I see it as something that will encourage us, and my boss, to do much more than we are doing before.
The people in the client's organizations, when these designs, in fact, they commission the consultants. They say what it is they want. The consultants help them to shape up what they want. And when they bring the concept, they are the ones who review it and determine whether it is conformance with what they want or not. And then when they also go ahead to the preliminary design, fine, they will bring it back, they will review and approve. When it comes to detailed engineering, the same thing.
Well, that's about all we have time for on Inside Business Africa for today. Thank you again for watching. But indeed, I would like to tell you that ABX is doing something unique for Nigeria. And indeed, everyone, every entrepreneur, government must encourage this organization to be sustainable, because the platform they are bringing in is quite unique indeed. And indeed, the fact that it's going to be bringing in quite a very large amount of foreign exchange to boost the nation's foreign exchange reserve is very key indeed. You want to know what they have been doing and also what they have done. And that was how we brought him to the program today on Inside Business Africa. Thank you again for watching. My name is Kenneth Odushola Stevenson. See you next time.